Hello traders and investors, welcome back to the Trend Trader channel. As some of you already know, for a very long time I've been trading the stock market using systematic trend following. For those that don't know what is systematic trend following, you can check one of the videos where we reviewed a book whereby the author and was reviewing trend following, and then the author touched a bit on the development or on one of the developments of systematic trend following. So, but the purpose of this video is not to do another book review. So in this video, I just want to say that I've had this idea for a while now. So basically what I want to do, I want to use a 10,000 rand on my Easy Equities account. I want to see if I trade stocks using systematic trend following, how much can I grow that 10,000 rand in a 6 months period. So today we are still in June 2021. I want to start trading that 10,000 rand in the beginning of July 2021. So if you are not familiar with systematic trend following, you can check in the description below. In such a tiny ebook on systematic trend following, that ebook is available on Gumroad. You can check it out there. It's selling for $12 US, and also you get some videos on how explaining the systematic trend following and also showing you how you can set up the charts on TradingView and some risk management tools that we use whenever we are using systematic trend following. But that's if you want to have an idea of how systematic trend following works and want to follow up in this. Okay, so now this crazy idea, I chose 10,000 rand because for beginner investors or investors who don't have a lot of money, 10,000 is not necessarily a small amount of money, but it's not that large. Many investors can raise 10,000 rand and invest it. But also for the more experienced traders and investors who has a large amount of capital to invest but want to diversify their investing or trading approach, 10,000 rand could be a reasonable amount of cash for them to test systematic trend following. Basically, it can allow them to diversify their investing strategy. So that's the whole rationale of choosing a 10,000 rand. It's sort of a sweet spot for beginner investors or investors who have limited capital, and also sort of a sweet spot for experienced traders or investors who have access to large amount of capital. So why systematic trend following? I've been using this approach for over 3 years now. Well, I started investing on Easy Equities in 2015, but I started as an investor. I was also looking at penny stocks like most beginner investors. And I also used to invest in companies that I liked. For some of those companies, they worked well. Some of those companies didn't work as I had anticipated. So I started to look for another way that at least suits my personality and my risk appetite. Then I found trend following. So I've been developing and testing different trading strategies that are based on trend following. And then up until the point whereby I said, okay, now I will be using a systematic trend following. But once you have a strategy and you already have an existing portfolio, it's not that easy to just cut all the holdings that you have and start from scratch. I mean, it's possible, but yeah, perhaps as a person you might not want to go via that route. So as a result, for the past 3 years I've been using systematic trend following, tweaking it there and there, because investing, it's a continuous improvement. You don't just come up with a strategy today and then say you're just going to stick to this strategy. Although it's important that you stick to one trading or investing strategy, the market changes all the time. So if the market change, you need to adjust the strategy so that it's still applicable in that particular market. Otherwise, if you just stick to one strategy as it is without changing it, you might experience large drawdowns, especially if the market is not suitable for that particular approach. Yeah, so the strategy that I'll be using is based on systematic trend following, and also we'll be focusing more on risk management and position sizing. Basically, what it means is that I will not be risking more than 2% of the total portfolio. In this case, the portfolio is going to be worth 10,000 rand. So 2% of 10,000 rand is 200 rands. This excludes fees, any fees that I'll be paying to the broker. Like I said, I'll be using Easy Equities. So that 200 rand is not the amount of money that I'm going to spend buying the shares. I'll buy the shares of any company for whatsoever value according to the position size, but I will be using a stop loss. Yes, as of this video, Easy Equities does not have a stop loss function, but that doesn't mean anything really, because let's say, for example, I'm buying Sasol. Sasol is currently trading around 215 rand per share. So I will use position sizing to estimate my stop loss. Let's say the stop loss is at 200 rand. So basically it means that if I buy 215 and my stop loss is at 200, for each and every share of Sasol that I'm buying, I'm risking 15 rand per share. Then I will calculate using 200 rand divided by 15. Well, if it was 10, it would be 20. So if it's 15, it's somewhere around 15 shares that I can buy. Then I will buy 15 shares of Sasol. If Sasol goes up, I make money. If Sasol, the share price drops, it goes to 200 rand per share, then I cover my position, I sell my stock, meaning that I would have lost 15 rand per share. Then if you multiply that with the number of shares, you should get closer to 200 rand. So that's what I mean by saying that I'll be risking 200 rand per share. I'm not saying that I'll be investing 200 rand for a certain share. No, it's just the number of shares. In this case, using Sasol as an example, 15 shares multiplied by 215, whatever value that you get there, that's the amount of money that I'll be investing. But if you look at it at the risk level, then you can see that I'm only risking 15 rand per share. So yeah, I'll be using systematic trend following. I'll be using a position sizing in order to limit the amount of risk that I'm taking, and I won't exceed 2% risk per position, meaning that for any loss, I don't want to lose more than 200 rand. So for 10,000 rand divided by 200 rand, that's 50, meaning that I will have 50 chances to try and make money in that 6 months. But the goal of this whole experiment is to see how much can I grow 10,000 rand in 6 months using systematic trend following, using risk management, and most importantly, being disciplined in following a systematic trend following. So if you want to know more about systematic trend following, just go to the description below. There's a link to Gumroad. It will take you to that ebook. Like I said, in the ebook, it's $12. If you want to buy the ebook and have access to all those videos and the Excel worksheet where we use risk management based on position sizing. But if you don't want to buy the ebook, there's an option to rent it for 30 days. You can rent it for $8. So depending on the exchange rate of the South African rand and the US dollar, today it could be 165 rand to buy that book, or to rent it, it's going to be less because it's $8. But now let's see. Like I said, I've been using this since the past 3 years or so. For this year alone, my portfolio is up by at least 23%. So if and I have a hit rate of about 50%, and typically my trades, they have about a 1:5 risk to reward. So in this case, I'm risking 200 rand, so the reward is somewhere around 1,000 rand per share. So with a 50% hit rate, if we take 10 trades using this strategy, and 5 trades are profitable, 5 trades are losses. So for the 5 profitable trades, there we can expect to make 1,000 rand. per trade. So the total profit that you're making there is 5,000 rand. Then the five other trades are not profitable because we're looking at a 50% probability to make profit. So the five trades with a 200 rand risk, that's about 1,000 rand that you are losing. So overall, 5,000 minus 1,000 rand, we are still left with 4,000 rand that you made in profit. I'm not implying that we are going to make 40% return on this investment. I'm just making an example, because if you develop a trading system, or if you use a trading system, not necessarily develop it, it's worthwhile to go back to the statistics to look at the data that you've been using. I mean, the types of trade, that will be your input, your data. Then you look at the win rate. You look at the profitability of your approach, because if you don't know the win rate of your strategy, you also don't know the profitability, then your trading approach might not have an edge in the market. So it's important to know, look at it, take 10 trades, not necessarily 10 trades at once, but as you are taking making investment or placing trades, once you have taken 10 trades and closed all those 10 positions, you can go back to your trades and look, say, okay, fine, I bought 10 stocks, I've traded 10 stocks, how many were profitable, how many were losses? And then you look at those that were profitable, how large were the profit? You look at the losses, how large were the losses? So that's what we are talking about. Then if you can do some bit of calculations there, you can see the expectancy of your approach. Basically, you want a trading system that has a positive expectancy. So I'm confident in trying this experiment, because I already know, based on the data that I have, that this approach has a positive expectancy. That is why I know that on average I can have a risk to reward of 1:5, meaning that my profit are 5 times larger than my losses. Well, my losses are fixed, because at any given period I don't want to risk more than 2% of my portfolio. But if I'm making profit on a particular position, I don't want to limit that profit to say 10%, 20%, 30%. No, as long as the market is profitable, the share price is still rising, I allow my trade to continue to go up. But if the share price moves against my position, I want to cap my loss at a particular preset stop level. So once you know that, the size of your losses, the size of your winnings, and also you've done a number of trades, then you can determine the win rate. Assuming that you have a win rate, you can determine that win rate. So if you win 50% of the time, half of your trades are profitable, half of them are not profitable. Because, I mean, I'm a trader, I do use a stop loss, so I know that losses are there, are inevitable. For some people, they buy companies based on whatever conviction that they have. So if the market moves against them, they still hold their shares. There's nothing wrong with that. There are so many different approaches that you can use to trade or to invest in the stock market. There's no right way to do it, there's no wrong way to do it. You just have to have a way that you are comfortable with as an individual. And then lastly, why are we using Easy Equities? Most of us already know that Easy Equities is one of the most affordable brokers in South Africa. And yeah, so it's affordable, that's one of their best selling point. Then the other thing is that maybe you might ask yourself, why am I not trading this in a form of contract for derivatives, what is known as CFDs, with brokers such as GT247 or IG? For many investors or traders, when the market moves against them, they chicken out, they don't want to close their position and take their losses for whatsoever reason. So if you use Easy Equities, you can buy your Sasol shares. If the share price move against you, you are not obligated to sell your shares. You can hold your shares even though the value of those shares might drop. So at least if you have a tendency to chicken out and not to follow your strategy, when it says exit, you don't want to exit, you can still keep your shares. But if you're trading derivatives, then because there you are just tracking or trading the price of the underlying security, in this case the shares, if the market moves against you, your broker, especially if they follow the no negative what policy, meaning that your account can't go to a negative balance, then your broker will be forced to close your position And as you know, every advert that you've seen where they're talking about CFD trading, they tell you that at least 65% of the traders, they lose their money. They also say that you can lose more than what you have invested. So that is why we are going to use a broker whereby we will be trading shares directly. We will have full ownership of the trade of the shares that we'll be buying. So this will help for those people that will chicken out, that at least at the end of the day they have something. So yeah, that's what I'm planning to do. By the end of this year, 2021, I will make another video to show all the trades during the period from July until the last trading day of 2021. I won't be making any updates on the trades that I will be making with this experiment. I will only give you an update at the end of the year to show you how many trades that I have taken, the amount of money that I've made, if I've made money, if the whole thing was profitable, or if this whole thing was a loss. I will just report, and then for each and every trade, I will say how much profit or loss we made or we took on the particular trade and the number of trade. Then I will calculate the win rate and the size of the profits and the size of the losses. Then we will see if we've made money or if we have lost money. So I'll be doing that. And again, if you want to participate, you can buy that ebook on Gumroad. And if you want support later on, once you've bought that ebook, well, Gumroad sends an email whenever there's a purchase. I will know who has purchased. If you want to be part of a group where we'll just be discussing the trading in general, not telling each other what to buy, what to sell. No, if you just need support, you can just shoot me an email, then we'll maybe create a Telegram group where we'll just be engaging each other there. But again, for us to engage in that, the catch is that you must buy the ebook on Gumroad. Otherwise, you can buy the ebook and do this whole thing on your own. I will only give an update at the end of this year. So that's it. I just want to see if I trade stocks using systematic trend following for 6 months, how much money can I make or lose in the stock market? I don't know how much I'm going to make. I have an idea how much I'm going to lose because I know the risk that I'm willing to take. Yeah, so I have an idea. I have 50 chances to make money based on the risk. Possible loss of 200 rand per share. I don't have an idea how much money I'm going to make because I know for sure I can't predict how high or how low the market can go. So if it goes high by so much, I will make that much. But if it goes low by so much, I know where to get off. So that's it for today. I will see you on the next video.